Hi everyone, and thank you for joining us for this new Twinmotion tutorial. In today's video, we will be looking at the home screen and the templates. The templates seen are a collection of projects that you can use to get started faster with your own project. Those are scene already built with lighting or different media already set up that will allow you to get started faster and obtain results in no time. In this video, I'm going to make a quick overview of each of those templates, the ones that are currently available when I'm recording that video, but keep in mind that many more templates are planned in the future, so you can expect to see that list growing. Let's have a look at the first one here, the architecture day and night skies. By default, those templates are not installed locally on your machine. They are only available on the cloud and available on demand. We do that to not raise the installation size of Twinmotion. That way, you can just download the templates you need when you need it. Here, I already downloaded that template, so here I have an open button at the top right corner of the screen. If you never downloaded that template before, it will be a download icon. Once downloaded, I can simply click on Open to launch that scene. The Day and Night Sky template contains many media already set up in the Media tab, but to better visualize that, I'm going first to import a small project. My project has been imported, but as you can see here, it's way above my camera. So we'll just navigate using my arrow key, take some altitude, and just try to find a position where I can see the wall of my project. Something like that. So now that's done, let's actually come to the Media tab, and here we have all the media that loads. All those cameras have been created at the origin of the Twinmotion world, where the camera was when I imported that project. So as you can see here, it's below the ground. If I want to move that camera where I actually am in the viewport right now, I can just press on that refresh button. That will just refresh the camera position, but all the settings set up in all those media will be saved. So here, for example, if I want to take that camera and bring it up here in my scene, I'll just press on refresh. And now I have actually automatically selected that camera, and I also have selected all the settings, so we can see that we have a different sky. And again, here the idea is that all those media are set up with a completely different mood and sky and also lighting. So here we have a nice sunset on that side. Here we have a city skyline with some glowing building. Here we have another sunset, but completely different. And again, here the idea is that once you find the sky and the lighting that you want, let's maybe pick that one here. You can of course customize it. So for example, here I will come to my property panel. I'm going to close all those tabs and just open the environment. And here I'm just going to rotate my HDRI. So the big advantage of this template is, like you can see here, there are a multitude of media already set up. So as soon as you import your file, you can already have a look at your project with different lighting scenarios. Let's jump now on the second template. To have access to the home screen again, you can click on the home icon at the top left corner of the screen. Now let's actually switch to the work table here. That template was designed as a real-life work table where a designer will set up and choose the material on his object or fashion piece. So that's why here in the middle of the scene we have that shoe with some clay material on it. The idea here will be for you to import your own model, replace the shoe that we have in the scene, and set up the material in that scene. And also to better visualize your shoe and how the lighting will affect it with the different material you will create, in the Media tab, there is also different lighting scenarios around the object. So again, let's actually import quickly an object. So here I just imported my headset. The first thing I want to do is actually replace the shoe in all the media that we can see here. I want to replace it by that headset. So I will click on my headset and I will click on Control on my keyboard and I will select in addition the small object placeholder. I'm going to right-click on that last one and click on Replace Container. So that will take the headset and that will make it visible in all the media already set up. So now if I come to my media, here we can see that the shoe is not visible anymore and we can see the headset in the different lighting scenario. What I can also do is maybe turn the headset a bit so we don't see it just from a front point of view, we see a bit the side. So now that my media are already set with the proper object, the idea again of that template is to set up material on that object. So that's what I'm going to do next. And that's it. Here I've created my materials. I'm pretty happy with the result so far. So here I can come now to my media. If I want to come a bit closer to my object, I will just navigate closer to it. Press refresh to memorize the new camera position. I can do the same just by clicking on that refresh button to just memorize the new camera position. And I can visualize my asset with those different lighting scenarios. Also, at any moment, I can press R or click on that icon to turn on the path tracer and see my object with a more realistic lighting. In that template, in the video section here, you will find also different videos, including a turntable, which allow you to visualize your object spinning. Same idea here, you want to go a bit closer, just move the camera and press refresh on the thumbnail to memorize the new camera position. And that's it for this template, let's have a look at a new one now. The next one I want to open is the basic lighting. This one contains two shoes and contains in the media all the media required to create a pack shot of your product. So here we have an image from one side, an image from the other side, an image from the bottom, we have an image from the top view, an image like that where we can see from an angle, and we can also see some close-up. Same idea here, you will need to import your object and replace the shoe present in the template by your own object. So let me do that right now. So here I just imported a new pair of shoes that I've texturized in my previous template. So now that is done, the idea will be to take each shoe and replace the placeholder folder that we have in the scene graph. This way, this will update all the media with the shoe in each position. Because right now, if I just open my media, we can see that here only the shoe is visible and on the right here we have the pair of shoes that I just imported. And I don't want to manually just move my shoe and place it in each position. There is an automatic process to do that. So here what I'm going to do first is select my right shoe. I'm going to click on Control on my keyboard, click on Right Shoe Placeholder. I will right-click on that folder and click on Replace Container. That will take my right shoe and replace the placeholder by that new one. I'm going to do the same process on that one here, Replace Container. And now if I click on all my media has been updated with the shoe in each of the different positions that we can see on the thumbnail. If I want the thumbnail to just showcase the correct shoe, what I will need to do is just press refresh to update the new thumbnail. Now that's done, I can just go into the render section and export my pack shot of the new shoe I just imported. Moving on to the next template, here I'm going to open the display plinth. In the display print template, same idea here. When you open the media, you have a collection of media with various plints. That's the base on which the object is sitting on. And there is also different lighting scenario. So here we have that simple background here, but you can switch to that one with some nice shadow. There is a more white one, or there is this color as well. And at each time you have a different print. Not going to import a new model on this one, but you get the idea. You can import your object, choose the print you want, and just render your image with that camera setup. Jumping on to the next template, the monochromatic one. All templates work in a similar way. There is always some media already set up. You have a scene graph where we can see some placeholder that you can replace by the object you import, and you can quickly render those images. For example, here in that monochromatic template, the idea is to visualize that watch. But again, you can completely replace that watch by a headset, a shoe, or whatever object you want to visualize. This is just a set of examples of render you can achieve with Twinmotion. Also, again, this is done in raster mode. At any moment, you can turn on the path tracer by clicking on that icon. Once you have imported your object and replaced the one that we have in the template, you can go just to the export tab, select the image you want to export, and click on start export. We are going to talk more about export in a dedicated video. And that's it for the template. Just bear in mind that when you will be watching that video, maybe new template will be available. More templates are currently work in progress, so stay tuned for more. And that's it for this video. Thank you everyone for watching it, and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone.